Whether you're using Rainbow in Max or in one of the available export targets, MIDI is one of the main communication methods that you can use to control your Rainbow patches. If you're already familiar with using MIDI in Max, the implementation is very similar in Rainbow. In this video, we'll cover everything to do with using MIDI in Rainbow and how you can control your patches with your favorite controller right away. To begin working with MIDI in your Rainbow patcher, create a note in object or a MIDI in object, and this will create a new inlet in the rightmost section of your Rainbow object. This is the MIDI inlet for your Rainbow patcher. This is where you should direct all your incoming MIDI messages to. For MIDI out, create one of the MIDI out objects. This includes MIDI out and control out, and a new outlet will be created for you at the bottom of your Rainbow object. This will always be the second to rightmost outlet of the Rainbow object, which can be connected to Max's MIDI out object, where you can select a port for where you would like your MIDI messages to be directed. All inbound and outbound MIDI messages are available to Rainbow subpatches. This means that MIDI in and MIDI out objects inside of Rainbow subpatches can send and receive MIDI directly without needing to be connected to the parent patcher. Let's take this simple synth patch and enable Polyphony by using the @Polyphony attribute with an argument of 8. This gives us 8 voices of Polyphony. This synth example has an oscillator subpatch containing 4 different waveforms, an ADSR envelope, and a state variable filter. Inside each of these subpatches, there are param objects. These can be used to modulate the synth in different ways. Right now, MIDI isn't connected to any of these parameters. So let's take some MIDI CC messages from our USB controller and connect them to some of these parameters. Let's start with an envelope. To map the attack, decay, sustain, and release parameters to our MIDI controller, first we'll need to connect our MIDI controller to Max. Make a MIDI in object in the top level Max patcher and connect it to the rightmost inlet of the Rainbow object, the MIDI inlet. Double-click the MIDI in object and select your MIDI input device. I'm going to select the Fader Fox. Back in the Simple Synth patcher, we have a note in object. This sends MIDI pitch to the oscillator and velocity to the envelope. The note in object doesn't give us access to MIDI CC messages. For this, we can use the control in object. Connect a print object to the middle outlet of control in and then wiggle some knobs on your controller. You'll see the controller numbers for each knob in the Max console. Create 3 new control in objects and use the controller numbers from the Max console as the arguments for each. These objects are now bound to each of the controller numbers. The controller values for each controller number will be available at the left-hand outlet. We can use a scale object to scale the incoming MIDI range to the output range defined by the parameter. Then we can use the set object with the name of the parameter to use the scaled MIDI value to set each of the parameters. You can use the same method for any Rainbow subpatcher that contains a parameter that you want to modulate. The bend in object gives us lots to work with for many pitch bend messages. Let's add it to our oscillator subpatch and create some polyphonic pitch bends. The MIDI pitch bend is entering via IN1 and going into the M2F object, which will convert the MIDI pitch into a frequency which is driving all of the oscillators. If we make a bend in with the attribute @BendMode1, we can use the left outlet to get a centered value between -1 and 1, which corresponds to the MIDI pitch bend value. If we want one semitone of pitch bend in either direction, we can add this to the incoming MIDI value using the plus object. If we then add at hot 1, this will make all inlets hot, which means we can modulate the MIDI pitch value without needing to use the trigger object. If you want a pitch bend that's greater than one semitone, simply multiply the center value by an integer. Let's use another parameter for this and we'll call it pitch bend range. We'll give it a default of 1 and a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 12, which is a full octave in either direction. Now play and hold a few keys on your MIDI controller and modulate the pitch bend. Since this is all happening in a polyphonic patcher, you can modulate all of the held keys at the same time. If we're happy with our MIDI mapping, we can export the patcher to our desired target and all of our MIDI mapping will be preserved. For more MIDI possibilities, check out the other videos and articles. Happy patching!